Hello everybody, welcome to the video tutorial of Ben Howard's These Waters. I'm gonna show you how to play this song. I broke it down into detail to be able to show you every single percussive beat and the fact that every verse differs from verse to verse and the chorus is not always the same and there's a difficult solo in the end. It's quite hard to learn, but I'm sure you're gonna make it. What I did is I took a live performance by Ben Howard I found on YouTube, in my opinion one of the best ones, and learned this performance, and I'm gonna go through that performance from the start till the end, step by step, so you see every single verse explained, every chorus explained, the solo explained, everything, because it's quite difficult to structure that into this is the verse and this is the chorus, because Ben Howard always changes the way he plays a little bit. Okay, so let's get started with the basics. What you need is a capo on 3rd fret covering all strings, and the tuning is open C. Open C is not the tuning Ben Howard uses in a lot of his songs. Usually he uses the C-G-C, G-G-C tuning, but in this case the two highest strings are higher, tuned up. The second string is tuned to a C, half a step up from the regular B tuning, yeah? And the first string is an E, like in the regular tuning. So it's C, G, C, G, C, E. When you tune your guitar right and you place your capo on the 3rd fret, it should sound like this. Once again. Okay, so we're well prepared for the song. Let's get started. Okay, let's start with the intro part. The intro part is fairly simple. Ben Howard's left hand plays 4th fret, low 3 strings, and 2nd fret, low 3 strings. And his right hand does some standard percussive part. I'd like to show you. He hits the low 3 or 4 strings near the bridge of the guitar. Does a percussive slap with his thumb on his guitar body. Does a slap on guitar side. Goes back, does a slap again on guitar body, and hits the bass notes again. With his left hand, he starts with an open strike. I saw. And then he starts with the left hand playing. And ends on the 2nd fret, low 3 strings. And that's where the verse starts, the first verse. Okay, let's proceed to the first verse. We ended up here, the last note of the intro part. And I'm gonna show you the verse. I play it one time so you hear what I'm gonna show you. Thank you. Okay. Your right hand sticks to the basic percussive part. It's doing in the intro part, and your left hand uses the fourth fret, fourth string, to do hammer-ons and pull-offs. Right? Simultaneously to the percussive stuff. Okay? Six times hammer-ons and pull-offs. One, two, three, four, five, six. And then on the next low beat, bass beat, your ring finger or your pinky holds down the low three strings on the fourth fret, and your right hand speeds up a little bit regarding the percussive clap on the top of the guitar and the side of the guitar, because after that clap on the side of the guitar, you have to play a hammer on pull off on 7th fret, 4th string. Sliding down to 2nd fret, doing the same with the right hand, but playing a pull off now on 6th fret, 4th string. Combined. That's the first part of the verse. After having played that, the first harmonic hammer-ons appear in the song. Now, let's get to the second part of the first verse. After that, you get a double bass note. Leading into the harmonic hammer-on and percussive stuff, which is quite difficult in the beginning. I want to slow that down for you. The harmonics in this tuning with the cap on 3rd fret are on the usually 15th fret, but now it's the 12th fret, and on the 7th fret, right? That's where Ben Howard's left hand hits the notes on the 12th fret 2nd string, and on the 7th fret, 3rd string. Also hitting the fourth string, and sometimes the 5th string, so you get a lower note than up here. Okay, so the second part of the verse starts with a percussive, with the bass beat near the bridge, some fingering on the guitar with the left hand, and some fingering with the right hand on the top of the guitar with your fingernails. That's quite easy. And now after that one, the first harmonic hammer-on is played. And after that hammer-on, you do the slap on the side of your guitar. And after that slap, you do the second harmonic here on the 7th fret. Right? And after the second harmonic, you do a basic slap with your thumb on the guitar. Playing the bass notes two times between. Right? So basically, that's the second part of the verse, but between this harmonic stuff, there's some little pause where Ben Howard is playing the calm passage with a forte voice of patience, just to let it lie down, and then it starts again with the. And this leads right into the first chorus. Okay, the first chorus. Let me show you what I'm gonna play, so you see the whole thing. Okay, basically the chorus also consists of two parts. The first part, you use your left hand on the 7th fret, 7th fret, 6th string and 4th string. 5th is open, right? And you play the bass note. After the bass note, you do some hammer-ons here with your right index finger or right middle finger, whatever you want to use. Actually, it was pretty hard to make out what harmonics Ben Howard plays and how often he beats on the fretboard. Actually, it doesn't really matter, because it sounds quite similar to the versions of Ben Howard, and I recognize that in many versions he plays it different. He varies from first bass note and two hits to bass note and three hits or four hits, and I think actually Ben Howard doesn't know what to play in this case. But the bass note with the two fingers on the 7th fret. Some hammer-ons, about two or three, then a percussive slap with a thumb on the top of your guitar. Bass notes again, that differs and varies from time to time. Sometimes he plays a single bass note, or he doubles, or he plays it three times. That also varies from video to video, so I suggest you find out what you personally like best. The first part. Yeah? Then your left hand, your index finger, after the first bass note, slides down one fret to a sixth fret. Here, sixth fret, sixth string. Sounds weird, but it's the way he plays it. And after playing that one, after that bass note, it goes back into the second part of the verse. and start again with the chorus part. I personally prefer playing three hammer-ons. The first three hammer-ons, a bit slower, and the second ones, three hammer-ons or four hammer-ons, also varying from time to time. And ending the chorus part on 2nd fret, low 3 strings. So I play it one more time. Okay, let's get into the second verse. The second verse begins right like the first verse with that hammer and pull off thing with your left hand. Yeah. And your percussive stuff with your right hand. And after two times playing this hammer-on stuff, hammer-on pull-off stuff, you go into that little, I would say, fill-in that also appears in the first verse and the chorus. Going into that strong hands to hold good friends that are never lost. Yeah, that's the calm passage you had in the first verse. Leading directly into that and after playing that two times, Ben Howard directly goes into the third verse, which is played slightly different to the second one. The third verse is played really, really different to the first and second verse. The thing with the right hand, with that percussive stuff here, is completely left out. He starts with a bass note and this hammer and pull-off thing, but doing just the hammer-ons and pull-offs without any other stuff. Yeah? Going into the 4th fret, low 3 strings. After that part, is this and these rows for wondrous lost is the heart. After that part, he does a little percussive technique with his right hand, playing the 4th fret low 3 strings and 2nd fret low 3 strings again. That's the part where he sings, chance to breathe again, a chance for a fresh start here, right? What he does is playing the bass notes, doing a little slap with his thumb on the guitar, and then doing some percussive stuff with his fingertips on the guitar. this. Percussive beats with his fingertips is left out and changed to the standard bass beats up here. The change from these beats to that also vary from video to video. I would suggest you, play like you want, like it pleases you best. And when the verse is done with this technique, it leads directly into the next chorus. Okay, the next chorus. Basically, the chorus is played like the other chorus before. And so on, but in this case, the first time after Ben Howard doesn't play that part. Instead of he plays right. Keeps playing till the end of the chorus, always the same, but the first time how is he gonna play this? He plays the bass notes and does some percussive stuff with the left hand, with the right hand. Left hand hits the guitar before the thumb of his right hand does. Okay, but the rest of the chorus is similar to the first one. So, after that chorus, we end up with that note again. Right? That's the last note of the chorus and leads directly into the solo part, which I'm going to show you now. Okay, the solo part. I'm gonna split that into two halves. I'm gonna show you the first half in kind of regular speed, and after that I'm gonna break it down so you can learn it, and I repeat that with the second half. So that's where we ended up from the chorus. Now the solo begins. That's the first part, and now I'm going to break it down for you. When we start here, we change to the 4th fret, low 3 strings, and the whole solo begins with a percussive slap of the thumb on the top of the guitar, and two beats on strings near the bridge. And then there's a lot of hammer-ons, a lot of percussive hammer-ons in this section here, almost the whole fretboard, only played by the right hand. In my opinion, bend changes between 7th fret and 12th fret. Right? Always changing between these two harmonic parts. We've done that percussive beat and the two bass notes. You hit the harmonics over here 4 times. Go back, do a percussive beat with your thumb, and hit the bass note again. And then you hit the harmonics 6 times. Then you switch to the percussive part with your right hand and harmonics with your left hand. Right? With the last bass note, you switch your hands, your right hand goes to the body of your guitar for the harmonic part. And now, this is quite difficult because it's going really fast, hard to figure out, but the first thing you hit is the body of your guitar, the top of your guitar with your right hand thumb. After that hit, there's the first harmonic hammer-on with the left hand on the 15th fret. Then there's a slap with your right hand on the side guitar, and then there goes the second harmonic on the 7th fret, right? After the second harmonic, there's another slap with the thumb on the top of the guitar and with the 4 fingers. Right? Yeah, let's play this once again in full. Second time you're doing this thing with the percussive part on the body of the guitar, there are 3 harmonics, not just 2. The first time there are 2. Thumb, harmonic, slap, harmonic. The second time there is thumb, harmonic, slap, harmonic, thumb, harmonic, and thumb instead of the slap with your full hand. It's thumb, harmonic, thumb, bass, right? Um, and that on the correct speed, and then you get the first half of the solo. Let's proceed to the second half. Let's get started with the second part of the solo. After the first part, the left hand sticks to the 4th fret low 3 strings, and the right hand plays a bass note, a slap on the guitar, and then a little pause and 2 harmonic hammer-ons. After that, a slap with the thumb on the guitar and 2 bass notes. And then 5 harmonic hammer-ons. So. Right? And this part is repeated over and over till the end of the solo. I think it's played about 4 times. And the third time it's played, Ben Howard slaps with both hands, both index fingers on the guitar neck to produce this harmonic sound. This is played after playing the 2 bass notes over here. So the first is, and then the 2 bass notes, 2 harmonic strikes with the right hand, and then the left hand comes on the 7th fret, right, and then gets back into the second part of the solo. And so on. And that's basically the second part of the solo, but Ben Howard plays it a little bit different. He uses his index, his pinky, instead of the index finger, to hold down the low 3 strings on the 4th fret, which I cannot do because my pinky is too weak. I'm sorry about that. And then he plays some harmonics. The first harmonic after that beat is the 7th fret, the 5th string. Did I say harmonic? I mean hammer on and pull off. Yeah. Right before playing the hammer-ons, the hammer-on harmonics with the right index finger, he's doing that pull off and hammer on and pull off thing here. And after the 2 bass notes, he's also playing that 7th fret, 5th string, but then in combination with the 9th fret, 5th string and 4th string. And that's why he uses his pinky to hold down the 3 strings, because it's far away from the 4th fret. And yeah, I think I'm just too bad for that. And I think I'm never gonna learn it. I didn't really practice it. I just watched Ben Howard playing that and copied that, and I know that he's playing it that way, but I never really practiced that because it's painful for my pinky after about 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, when you've done that part, that solo part, it leads directly to the last chorus, but before he plays the chorus chords again, he does that fill-in thing you've already learned before in the verses and the chorus, that right? yeah, he's doing that quite between the solo and the last chorus. And yeah, that leads us directly to the last chorus. I'm going to show you what he's playing there. Okay guys, this is the last part of the song, it's the last chorus. If you've managed to learn the song so far, then this is absolutely no problem for you. But now he plays the same with his left hand like he does in the other chorus parts. 7th fret, 6th and 4th string, and 6th fret, 6th string, right? You remember that? Let's slide down with the index finger. And then it plays open. The same story like in the first choruses. And his right hand plays a little bit calmer. There's not much hammer-ons and stuff. He's just playing the simple beat. Then doing some... Right? Already learned. So you can stick to that and end the song like this, or you can play some harmonic hammer-ons if you want. And how it does that in this version, I think the last two times he's playing that row here, he uses the hammer-ons again. Yeah, so it's you can play it like you want. You can play it either that way, changing to, or you can play hammer-ons all the time. It's a chorus. It's yeah, it's up to you how you like it best. And the final note Benhaus plays is the 7th fret, low 3 strings, hammer-on with his index finger or middle finger or whatever, and holding down the strings, right? Yeah, and that's how the song ends. Okay guys, the tutorial is done. It's late in the evening and I'm really tired now. Please, if you've got any questions, if there's anything you want to know about it, anything I can help you with, don't hesitate, write comments, write me a personal message, whatever you like, I'm trying to help you. Yeah, it took a lot of time, far more than Under the Same Sun, for me to learn the song and to put together a tutorial about it. It was a lot of work, it wasn't that simple, it wasn't that easy. I hope I could help you with all you wanted to know. I hope I could break it down for you so it was easy to follow. Don't be sad about the second solo part that I didn't really play with the pull-offs and hammer-ons and stuff. I really tried to, but it was quite difficult and would have cost about another 1.5 hours just to learn the solo, right? And if you want to learn that, I did explain how to do it. You can learn it. I would appreciate it if you appreciate my work with a like or a subscribe or a comment. Tell me what I can improve for the next tutorial that's coming in a few weeks, few months, whatever. Give me feedback, I would really like to. And yeah, you can suggest other tutorials, and I will see what I can do. So, good night, guys.